and the epilogue. Hey.
I was quite surprised to learn that Cornelius is the Prince of Titania. But who cast the Pooka's curse on Cornelius?
Oh, you too? Yeah, they brought me here too. This place is like a dream. I'll set up a shop and compete with the others.
I'm sorry I brought a stranger. This guy wanted to tag along and just wouldn't take no for an answer.
And I can. Level up. Okay. Let's continue.
I hope you are well, Your Majesty.
What in the world are the Palya doing? Allowing intruders in this place?
Those blockheads are guards. You might as well welcome the grave robbers who come to steal your jewels.
You may trick my servants, but your spells do not deceive me, sorcerer.
Beautiful Queen of Night, please rein your anger.
I would be even more beautiful if I rouged my face with your blood.
Like all who live, I have certain desires. But if you listen to me, I can erase your Majesty's worries here and now.
Worries?
If I may borrow your army, I shall bring you the soul of the jewel thief.
Do not attempt to fool me. I shall not allow an act that will ultimately cause the world's end.
Then Odin shall continue to do as he pleases. How unfortunate, Your Highness.
Just what do you seek?
Allow your dread army to appear in Arion for a short period of time. Say a sorcerer stole your Majesty's eye and called the dead out. And after the Demon Lord dies, you shall punish us.
So you would throw your life away just to fight the Demon Lord?
If I can only serve at Your Highness' side, then I shall be content. There are many among the dead who harbor ill will towards Odin. I ask to borrow those resentful souls. Oh, Cornelius is quite a man to watch. I'm beginning to regret deceiving and cursing him.
So it was you. How could you do something so evil?
There's more to me than you realize. I escaped serving that old man, but I made you my scapegoat instead. And when he whipped you, I hid.
I had to be repentant if I wanted to live.
But I couldn't protect you.
Ingwe.
It's time. Live out your days in peace, sister.
What?
That devious woman. It appears she kept her promise and sent troops to attack. She believed my words, but if she sees my mystic power, she'll change her mind. If the Halya come this way, I shall easily be able to sneak in.
I had heard that the Book of Transformation had disappeared from Titania. No, that can't be. Ah! Ingwe, wait!
And the frame drops. In a while. I also realized that I need to look up the real order to... the real order to get the real, the true ending for the game. Because it's easy to fuck up.
Let's go.
All right.
Ah!
Frame drops again. Probably gonna do this. Gonna try and end. The story, and I'm gonna end the game on Sunday. Seriously. Okay. Okay, I don't know what's going on right now, but the frame drops are happening, so I'm gonna end the stream now and continue on Sunday, because it's dropping like crazy, so... Hello and welcome back. As you can see, I bring her up to level 44, so I shouldn't have too much problem now with defeating the bosses and the... And hopefully, this entire stream will go well. Drink some water. Because I want to finish this today. That's why I also started an hour earlier than usual. so that I can make it in time. I have about 8 hours. I should be able to make it. Watching all the bad ends and the true ends. Now I can't remember exactly how. I did write it down. Question is, where did that paper go? I probably lost it. I probably lost it. I probably did. Excuse me a moment, I'm just gonna turn off this found it. Okay. I'm not gonna waste time with going around the entire place. No, I'm gonna go straight to the boss. Oh, frame drops again. Okay, I'm gonna do these things quickly. Gonna restart right back. You see, this is also a reason why I want to start earlier, because look at this shit. I don't know why I keep getting frame drops nowadays. I'm gonna head straight for the boss. I'm not gonna pick up the chest. Of habit. Okay, let's make something just so that I get the more. Is it called? Ozones. Okay. one more. Oh. Healing, that's good. And I can't make anything else.
This disturbance, is this your doing, Ingwei?
I take it you can see through my disguise.
None of my soldiers masked themselves.
'Twas a mistake, but I didn't think this could be finished without using my trump card.
Trump card?
Ingwei!
Velvet, 'tis you.
Ingwei, please don't use that power. Ingwei, please!
Why did you follow me? It was a mistake to let you keep that cipher. Now is the time to let you in on a secret. Velvet. It was me. I destroyed Valentine.
What?
Back then, if I hadn't known that this man was our father, if I didn't know his battle plans and know that he didn't stand a chance, I wouldn't have made the cauldron run amok.
No, you...
I didn't think it would cause such destruction. You were protected by the cipher and escaped the curse and disaster. I was saved because I was hiding in the cauldron's shadow. I watched the kingdom fall into ruin before my very eyes.
And I was spared, as you had intended.
You talk as if you understand me. In order to save my father, I destroyed an entire kingdom. Can you imagine the pain I feel? I still remember what you said when you looked down at me.
You did well, traitor. Now the cauldron is mine. There were other soldiers nearby. I could not call you my son.
You don't remember, do you? You didn't care at all. Your eyes and heart were full of grief for the cauldron.
No. Is that why you gave the ring to Eltharia?
I'd rather the fairies have it than give it to you. That must hurt the Aesir.
You.
I will pay for my sins with my life. I shall be cursed, and I will die. If I am the only one who is to suffer my mother's curse, then so be it.
Stop it, Ingwei!
But I will take you and the cauldron to my grave with me. Try using your magic. If you think you can surpass the power of Darkova...
Okay! Time to do this!
Let's go.
Transformation aborted. I couldn't finish the spell. Don't interfere, Velvet. Mother wished for my death.
No! Listen to me, Ingwe.
Don't worry about me. Go escape now!
Back then, we were scared. Scared that our grandfather would kill us. So we swore in front of him. Swore that we didn't love our mother when she was standing right there. She was crying then. But she didn't cry from the pain. She was happy that we chose the path of life instead of death at his hands. She knew that she could not escape death. If we sided with her, we would have been killed also.
That's not true. We had forsaken her. We didn't lift a finger to save her. That's why she cursed us before she died.
Grandfather was hiding this. It's the second part of the memo she wrote to us. She writes of her love for both of us.
That can't be true. I abandoned her.
You're safe, Your Majesty. There they are. Kill them before they do more harm.
Wait. Those two are...
It looks like this is the end for us, Ingwe.
Over here! Hurry!
Prince Cornelius.
You must be wondering about Ingwe. He left his bed, and we haven't found him. But I'm certain he will appear again.
Have you seen my father? He's badly injured, but he's run off.
Master Croy?
Princess Velvet, I finally have the answer. I have to tell you.
Master, please rest.
No, this is important. Listen to me. As the sorcerer said, the epic poems detail the path leading to the world's end. But 'tis not the path to becoming king. That path has been seen. In our country's prophecies, this is the path that must be avoided.
Master!
Even if this interpretation is correct, the outcome is horrible. Two humans survive the end of the world. Princess Velvet, only two will be... spared.
Father!
Master Croy.
That's depressing.
This scroll has the details. Please use the utmost care and try to avert the Armageddon. Perhaps that is your duty and your destiny.
Whoa! Okay. Saga Psalm 2. A fear it sticks thy beast speeds the guiding hand of salvation. The one who removes the torment is mine own son. The six-eyed beast must be Darkova, the three-headed demon beast. The section is based on the prophecy by a great king of Titania. Therefore, the one who removes the torment is my own son. It's thought to refer to the bloodlines of the Titania royal family. And if the beast feasts on man, then most likely no human can defeat it. But it's unthinkable that a non-human would be king. But it is unthinkable that a non-human would be king of Titania. Unless, of course, he is cursed, as we are, and is longer than human. Hint, hint. One that threatens the darkness is the shadow of the lost master. Prophecy's second phase, the unleashed frenzy of death. Something seems odd about these faces. Odette, queen of the dead, has no master. If the lord of the netherworld is not Odette, then what being can emerge from the netherworld? Only King Gallon, who is chained in the netherworld, comes to mind. Will he lead the army of the dead to his own country? Having read the Psalms based on the theory, the late master is Odette, and the shadow that threatens King Gallon is the shadow of Death? I heard that there is a swordsman who bears the shadow of death in the fairy kingdom, but could that be? The looming blaze comet burning down the forest. The flood of fire that man cannot withstand is halted by the world tree and vanishes. Evidently, King Onyx's army from the fire kingdom will sweep the land at Armageddon. The saga says that mankind cannot resist, but the world tree destroys the army. Yet this world tree exists only in myth. There's no such tree in this world. The second clue is in the prophecy. Scorches the throne's surroundings. Does that mean that the throne itself does not get scorched? If so, it could be a suggestion that one on the throne is able to face the flames. The cauldron is of course the cauldron. When the princess efforts are in vain, the nightmare repeats and then Armageddon will begin. So our king will trigger it. Proof blades and arrows are unleashed. The floating fire cannot be stopped. It can only be chained. The only weapon that can destroy the cauldron are ciphers. Something that is not a blade or an arrow can chain it. We are newcomers to this land, so we are not of the ancient blood. The one who controls the cauldron is a Valentinian who holds a cipher made of chain. In other words, it must be Mistress Velvet. If the baby dragon Master Cornelius saw its Leviathan, as the king said, then it will be an eternity before it matures and devours the world. It is written that the dragon's craft is lovely but yet inevitable. Born in chaos and fire sleeps in mother's arms. What is his mother that puts the lord of snakes to sleep? With the dragons Sindel, Wagner and Belagon, it's unlikely that the mother is a dragon. Then what is the mother in the songs? In the prophecy, the phrase devours the stone of blood can be taken to mean a red magic stone created in the cauldron. Even if Leviathan can be stopped by the red stone, the Armageddon cannot be stopped. The demon lord must have made Balor in anticipation of this. Welcome to Cromwell's Lord. The last psalm explicitly states that the world will be revived. The demon lord and the magi have taken this to mean that whoever survives Armageddon will become the new kings of the world. The demon lord served victory through wars, and the mages tried to control the Armageddon directly. Yet they were all mistaken. The two lords that survive will be chosen from the five challengers of the disasters. Read it. The two lords are said to be crownless. I suspect that lord is not meant to suggest royalty, but something else. Finally, here is the conclusion and my findings. This is conjecture from Psalm 5. Life disappears from the land. All comes to an end. One can only imagine a barren world with a tiny population. By Cronla's lord, could this mean the ancestors of mankind in the new world? If so, it will by necessary have to be two humans, a man and a woman. Then we can presume that the mother is in Zorn 5 can be understood as the one who defeats Levant and becomes the mother of the new world. Everyone other than the two humans will perish. How can this be in any way considered salvation? I hope that I am misunderstood the prophecies. There's a theory about the prophecy of the Armageddon left behind by the three wise men. The following pages are an excerpt from this literature. Lots of text. The sacred rite performed by the now lost Valentians, King Galon had turned into a three-headed demon beast, and as in the prophecy, King Galon will save the world. The Lord of the Netherworld in the saga is Queen of Death. The looming blade is the Infernal King Onyx. If the King of Titania releases his mystic power, overpowers the other nation, and sees the Colon, the Netherworld and the Fire Kingdom will go to war. The three great dragons will be eradicated, and the end shall come to us. But fear not, the world will be saved in the end by the arrival of a new king led by a guiding hand. The original manuscript written by the three wise men cannot be found. It must be mentioned that the theory is only an assumption based on the prophecy.
Phew!
That was a lot of text. And I will be right back. I need to quickly stretch my legs.